Thank you for being back in time. Welcome to the second keynote on the topic of 3D cadaster. I'm very happy to welcome Peter van Osterom from Delft University. Anyone who has any dealings with 3D GIS or 3D cadaster in the last few years, or actually many years back, has certainly come across Peter's name. So I'm very happy that he made it here. Almost specifically, just for that conference, he added a few days of holidays, I heard, in the area. But I'm very happy that you're here. I will not make a long introduction because I would really like to give the floor to you. If you want to move up here. Among many things, he is the co-author of a book, 3D Cadaster in an International Context, Legal, Organizational, and Technical Aspects. And he is also a full professor at TU Delft at the Department of Geomatics and many, many more things. I think you can all Google him if you'd like to learn more about Peter. So I save the time and give you the floor. I'm happy to have you here.
Many thanks. Vielen Dank für die nette Einladung. Merci beaucoup pour la invitation. Stefan, Lorenz, thank you very much for this very nice invitation. It's a big honor to be here in Switzerland at the 3D GeoInfo conference. I would like to know who has background in cadaster land administration professionally. So it could be industry, could be government, could be education. Okay, that's good. That is very good. Right, audience. Who knows what LRDM is? Okay, that is also good because there's a lot to learn. I will tell you something about LRDM and indeed version 2. LRDM stands for the Land Administration Domain Model. So it's an international standard in our field. We try to harmonize the concepts. It is about 3D cadaster, but as you can see from the title, it's more than that. It's also about 3D valuation for taxation. It's about 3D spatial planning information. It's about development of the cities. So together, this information is the core of a smart city information infrastructure. And as you can see, this is really teamwork. I will first give you a brief recap on what LRDM is, the Land Administration Domain Model, and then take you into step two, the version two. Dive into three topics a bit further, 3D cadaster, 3D valuation, 3D spatial planning information. And then I will show a little bit more about further revision topics in the standard, 3D indoor environments, 3D marine, and some other small topics. Okay, what is land administration? And there are many definitions, but I like this one by the United Nations. It's the process of recording and disseminating information about ownership, value, and use of land and associated resources. So that could be buildings or forests. So ownership, value, and use. So what is the Land Administration Domain Model? That's an ISO standard since 2012. It's an information model describing the main concepts. It includes a spatial part, geometry, topology, surveying, and it includes a legal part about the rights or restrictions, responsibilities that parties have on these spaces, or they are called spatial units in the terms of LRDM. And RRR means right, restriction, responsibility. So that are the relationships between land and people. So a parcel or a spatial unit is one of the key concepts. It has a number of specializations. It can exist in 2D and in 3D in this ISO standard. It can be a simple text description. It can be a single point. It can be a polygon, it can be topology structure. And it tries to integrate both 2D and 3D representations without complicating the existing 2D registrations. LRDM revision is a process that is trying to keep LRDM alive. It started already 2 years ago by a number of workshops, a UN meeting, the GGM, Global Geoinformation Management Group, and an FIG workshop on LRDM, and an inventory was made to gather requirements what should be included in the future version of LRDM. LRDM is an ISO standard, so at the past ISO meetings there was discussion on this new content, a new scope, and these are now described in what is called a stage zero document, where all the gathered requirements are collected. Here is another view what land administration is. On the left we have land tenure, or legal security about ownership. That was the scope of the current version of LRDM. And this is a picture of Stig Enemark. And then we see that land administration has these other aspects, as also in the UN definition, like land value, land use, land development, or plant use, spatial planning. And in the future, the scope of LRDM will try to cover all these aspects, so land administration in the broadest sense. To give you an impression of how it works with an ISO, perhaps you know, perhaps you don't know. Of course, Switzerland is the ISO country, with the office in Geneva of ISO. But normally it takes 4 years from a start to a finished standard. And now we are really at stage zero, which is this preliminary document where the requirements are collected. And that was submitted and approved to ISO TC211, the Geoinformation Committee, in last month, July 2019. And as you see, there are many more steps to be followed, a working draft, a draft international standard, and in the end, in step 60, we arrive at an international standard. But by then, it will be 2022, something like that. Member states of this ISO committee have nominated their experts, and here you see a list. And I was surprised that there was nobody from Switzerland. So perhaps this slide helps to motivate you. Please participate. There's a lot of interesting stuff that will happen the next couple of 4 years. Okay, this was a bit of the basics of LRDM. Now quickly move to the 3D cadaster topic. This was last month in the New York Times, newspaper in the United States. Catchy headline. And they were talking about selling air rights for $11 million. Neighbors of a certain parcel wanted to keep the nice view and bought the next door 3D air rights. And this is quite an expensive 3D parcel, $11 million. So it's one example of a 3D parcel, just air. But $11 million. Here are some other examples, often related to constructions, buildings, apartments, or infrastructure, pipelines, networks below the surface or above the surface, marine environments with the seabed, the bodies of water, the surface of the water. Or even archaeology can be above surface, below surface. Here are examples of possible 3D parcels because there may be restrictions on further development. So LRDM has spatial units, which are parcels. They have been possible to describe them in 3D in LRDM version 1, the current version. And it's kind of extending the 2D parcel into a 3D concept. And so instead of having just points, lines, and areas, we have points, lines, areas, and volumes, if we talk about the structure and topology. We have a lot of 2D maps, so we don't want to get rid of them. We want to reuse them. And actually, nobody is using just the surface. You're always using space above and below the surface. So realizing this, we can convert 2D parcels into a 3D interpretation, which is actually the column of space implied by this 2D parcel or 2D spatial unit. So we call them face strings, a series of boundary faces. But of course, you have more complicated 3D parcels. Some are very big. The left one is more than 10 kilometers wide. It's a mining area in Australia, subsurface 3D parcel. In the middle, you see a building example with complicated configurations. And we try to make a classification of the types of 3D parcels in order of simple to complex. So the most simple one is actually a 2D, which is then semi-open, goes up to infinite. The second one is a slice out of that with horizontal faces. And getting more and more complicated is having a number of these slices with different height values, horizontal planes. Category 6 is also interesting. There we kind of describe the parcel by referring to a construction or a building, which is the general boundary principle, and not using just coordinates, but using an object to describe the parcel. And if you have a 3D parcel of any shape, if you take it out of the column of a 2D parcel, then you have some kind of a remainder, and that's what we call the balance spatial unit or parcel. LRDM version 2 contains spatial profiles describing these 3D types of parcels from simple to complex. So this is the simple 3D parcel, which is a semi-open or a layer of 2D parcel. This is the example of a spatial profile where the geometry is described by referring to a building or a construction. And that can be a BIM IFC document. However, it has to be stressed that just having an IFC document does not always give you the property units. There's a lot of detail there, but not per se what are the different units. So it's important that there are certain guidelines for this IFC document where it becomes clear what are the property units. Okay, that is what is possible now and prepared for the future in LRDM version 2 on cadastre. Now, 3D valuation. Valuation is a new topic in the context of LRDM. It belongs to land administration. See the picture of stick and the markets, the second column, land value. And at the moment, there is no internationally accepted information model for valuation. And a number of countries raised how high the need was to have this kind of model in the revision of LRDM. So we decided to design an evaluation information package. And the main designer of this was Abdullah Kara. He's from Turkey. This is the model. I will not explain all classes in detail, but it are 10 new classes added to the standard. The first one is valuation. It's describing the method of valuation, the type of input and output. Mass appraisal, many valuation objects are assessed at the same time. The method is explained over here. The valuation unit, and what is the individual unit, which is text, can be a combination of a number of parcels and buildings, can be a part of a parcel or a building, and so on. There's no time to explain everything, but it also includes the sales statistics, because valuation should really be aligned with the market, the real estate market. Then the 3D aspect. Okay, knowing the 3D rights or restrictions, knowing the 3D physical objects is part of the value. But there's a lot more in 3D. For example, the views that influence the value. How much can you see? What can you see? Is it the ocean? Is it a mountain view? Also the noise, 3D noise models, hazards, crimes, floodings. They're all having 3D aspects. We tried doing this assessment by 3D views and compute view sheds for a building at different levels of the building. Of course, you see more from the higher levels. So that is the top one. This is the yellow and the orange. And then the level below is the orange and the red. So you can see that the top floor sees more. So that is potentially of a higher value. And this information should be able to be included in the information model for valuation. And here is the proposed extension with a number of classes and code list for these 3D valuation aspects. Another very new part of LRDM version 2 is spatial planning information. So again, a different world. There's a mismatch today in most countries of the world between the land registry, cadaster, and the planned land use information. They're not integrated, they are maintained by different authorities. Not using the same conceptual model, it's not possible to use the information together. So here's a part of the world, we have a road, we have a block. And okay, the part of the space is used by utility infrastructure, this yellow. There are pipelines and cables and sewer systems over there. Then we have the parcels, the ownership parcels, the black lines you see in 2D. Then we have the actual buildings, in red commercial buildings, in blue housing, and in gray a factory. Then we have the spatial plans or the zones. So we have a commercial zone, the light blue, and we have a housing zone, the red area. If we combine that and put it together, we see that it does not always fit. The different zones are not really 2D zones, but they have a 3D aspect. They have a certain height, maximum depth, which is allowed, you see, with the blue box and the light gray box. And you see that our buildings are sticking out. And so these parts now with a cross are kind of mismatches because of the spatial planning information, cadastral information is not aligned well. So we need integrated information. Again, this diagram of Enermark. On the left, we see activities normally conducted by cadastral land administration offices, and on the right, information by the spatial planning authorities about land use and land development. Okay, this is the model that was proposed. The main author of this model is Agun Indrajit. It has five classes. The main one is the planning units, grouped into blocks. We reused existing projects, for example, INSPIRE, an EU project Planned for All, to use the definitions for our key classes in the information model. That's also what we did, by the way, with valuation. There are no international standards for the information model, but there were standards, for example, for measurements, doing measurements. So we reused these existing standards. So now we can do more integrated delivery of information, dissemination of information from the whole land administration sector about allowed height or building ratio of a certain area. Okay, these are the three main components: cadaster, valuation, spatial planning information. Some other topics which are addressed in the revision of LRDM is the topic of 3D indoor environments. We spent a lot of time indoor. And they are full of rights, but also restrictions, where we are not allowed to go, or responsibilities. And in that sense, a building is kind of similar to what we do with land administration. We want to register who is allowed where. The patient in a hospital or a doctor in the hospital have different rights. And the same in a university building, the professors and the students have different rights. And so we want to represent that, and we are trying to combine the indoor GML model from OGC with LRDM. So this is the thinking. We see indoor GML on one side as a source of 3D parcels going through LRDM. And we use the rights, restrictions, responsibilities of LRDM, that type of modeling in indoor GML, so we can plan better routes. So this is the complex model, and you see in blue the LRDM classes and in red indoor GML. So this is link one. The cell space in indoor GML is a 3D geometry for a spatial unit or a parcel in LRDM. And the spatial unit with the attached rights is a source for indoor GML to know about the rights and restrictions so we can do better planning. And we see a stack of models, so at the bottom, indoor GML, LRDM. Together they make a conceptual building model. Then we have different types of building models, university buildings, hospitals, shopping centers, transportation buildings that are more specialized. And then we have specific buildings like R building. Another integration is with the marine environment. The International Hydrographic Organization is having standards for the marine world about the boundaries and limits on sea. And they use LRDM concepts to model who as the evolved rights, who has the responsibility for a certain part of the marine environment. And that is not a 2D, but it's actually a 3D situation. And if we look at the standards, their standard is called S121, you see a lot of LRDM classes being reused. For example, the persons, what's called the party, with the party and the party group and the party membership, exactly the same as LRDM. If you look at the rights and restrictions, exactly the same as in LRDM. And so we see a lot of 3D marine developments based on LRDM. Okay, the last few minutes for much more, what is also to be included. And everything I say now is not sure. And we have to go into this 4-year process in ISO to find consensus to develop this new standard. So these are a number of topics that I did not present, but that will be addressed. Very important are the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals to derive land indicators, to see, okay, how is the world progressing. We want to also have a refined survey model, more detail in the survey. We have code lists with important values about the type of rights. It could be ownership, lease, but we want to make them semantically rich. LRDM 1 is about information only. In LRDM 2, we also try to address processes. For example, if we want to record transactions, we want to show best practice process using blockchain technology. LRDM is a conceptual model. To implement it, you first have to develop a country profile, what is needed in a specific country, or in the case of Switzerland, in a canton. And you have to develop that. We want to make also some guidelines for implementations. And the next step is not a conceptual model, but a technical model in various encodings. For example, Interlis or RDF, GeoJSON, BIM IFC for different parts of the model. And I highlighted two things here. One was Interlis, because it's from Switzerland. I'm not going to explain why Interlis is so good, but Interlis is also going into the third dimension. And there is one encoding of Interlis of LRDM and the whole stack of ISO standards below. So here you see the ILI documents. The second thing I want to explain to you a little bit more is a code list. So that's the actual values of a type of a person or the type of a right or the type of a parcel. And in version one, they were just meaning, values without a meaning, just labels. We want to make them semantically rich. And versions, a definition may change over time of a code. We want to make them structured, giving them a hierarchy, like SCoRS, simple knowledge organization structure. And here you see an example, again, in Interlist of an versioned and hierarchical code list implementation. For code list, we also have to have practical issues. Who is maintaining the code list? Who's allowed to edit the code list, add new values, change values? Okay, in summary, LIDM version 2 is a big project. It will be a multi-part standard with the valuation, with the spatial planning information. We'll have better support for 3D and also 4D with the temporal dimension. A lot of organizations are involved, FIG as initiator, but it's of course the ISO umbrella. The World Bank is very important because they require ISO standards to be used in projects that they are funding, FAO for the agricultural parcels, and so on. To conclude, if it will all succeed, LIDM version 2 will cover the complete land administration domain, not just tenure, legal security, but everything. I think land administration is the foundation of our information infrastructure, of our geo-information infrastructure. Actual data collection and the maintenance and the integration of the different domains will be at local level, city level, and also the creation and the using and the maintenance of links between the 3D legal spaces, the parcels, and the real objects, for example, BIM. And we have to involve multiple organizations. That makes it also rather complex. And we have to have the collaboration of different disciplines like law, surveying, evaluation, spatial planning, ICT, and so on. International standards bring the benefit of global experience, benefit of scale, implementations by industry, and they form a basis of harmonization. So I think LIDM version 2 will be a very suitable core information model for a smart city 3D geoinformation. Not only cluster evaluation planning, but also more, as you saw in the previous slides. And one advertisement, the next LIDM workshop will be in more or less a month from now in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Thanks for your attention.